Welcome back. If you're new here, my name is Chrissy and this is Chrissy's Closet. I'm a part-time reseller based out here in New Jersey. I've been reselling for the past 6 years. I resell on many different sites, sell on eBay, Poshmark, Depop, and Vestiaire. And today is my What Sold April video. Okay, so we have a lot to cover. I think this will be my first video where, no, it's not my first video. My last What Sold, I said everything that sold. But I had an abbreviated month in March because I traveled, and so I had to close my store down for a week, and that did affect sales. So we're back up and running. I feel like my ring light is just bringing light over here, so it looks kind of crazy, but we're just gonna let it be. So yeah, I think that's my intro. I really want us to just get into it because I think it's a lot, but we'll see how long this is, okay? So what you should do is if you're listing or steaming or doing whatever you need to do to prep your items, what is Courtney from Comtex work with me? Think of this as a work with me. Put me on in the background and yeah, let's see if we could breeze through it. So let me give you some stats for April. I'm going to look down because my computer is down here. So a couple of things. I will post a picture, of course, of the listing up here. Just so you know, Poshmark takes 20% of whatever the sale is. So I don't have to keep saying this sold for this and this is how much I earned. Nope. Poshmark takes 20%. eBay takes probably like 18%. I don't remember what Depop takes. I feel like, I don't know what Depop takes. I'm going to say it's like 15%. But I don't think I have too many Depop sales. And yeah. No, I don't have a Vestiaire sale, but I'm still working on Vestiaire. And they didn't pay me for this, but I use Vendu to list. And now you can, whatchamacallit? Now you can list Vestiaire through Vendu. Oh, so if I have a referral link, I am going to link that below. All right, so my stats for April. My total sales was $2,288.02. The number of sales I had was 69 sales. My total average day listed, I don't know why, mine says 200 days. That's a long time. It's not, I guess it's not that bad, but yeah, 200 days. And so here's the breakdown of it. Majority of my sales was my own closet. And I tell you guys, even if you're a reseller, right? Which I think you should do, you should start with your own home. Whatever you have in your closet, sell your kids, sell your husband, sell your friends, your grandmas, whatever. Inventory is great at home. If you purchase it, someone else will purchase it too. So, you know, a lot of us are changing seasons because we're going out of winter into spring. So a lot of us purged our closet. And like I did, I found a lot of stuff. So I added it to my rack and I listed it. And yeah, and I always do that. So yeah. So my own 36% of my sales was my own closet, followed by my favorite thrift stores that I went to. And I'm still finishing up my liquidation. I had bought Free People liquidation lot last year. I feel like it was, August, September time. And I just want to get through them. Like, everybody and mama bought the Free People liquidation lot, and I'm like over that. So happy some of that stuff is selling. Okay, 57 of my sales was on Poshmark, 10 were on eBay. Oh, and I had 2 Depop sales for April. So that's that breakdown, and let's begin. April 1st, I sold this Vichy pink dress. I sold it for $25 on Poshmark. I actually wore that dress, so I was happy to sell that. Eloquii, next up is this Eloquii eyelet tie front full skirted maxi dress. That sold for $75 on Poshmark. I'm going to stop picking up Lululemon. Next up is this Lululemon Get Going dress, size 8. It's beautiful gray dress. I thought it was going to sell for more. I got an offer for $30 on Poshmark and I just let it go. I listed that probably with this. It does. Okay. I know the date that I picked it up. I picked it up in February 4th. So I must have listed it within that week. It didn't sell till April 2nd. And I don't know, Lululemon used to sell fast and I am impatient with my inventory. I am not the person that's, slow down, fast nickel, whatever. That saying, I'm the fast one. I want it in and out because there is good stuff out there. I'm never worried about not running into if I find a brand for the first time, I'm not like, oh, I'm going to hold on to this to get top tier price because I will come across it again. I'm pretty sure about that. Next up was this Liliana Mabel one square open toe weave shoe. So I'm reading off my list instead of actually looking at the listings. So okay, weave mule sandal size 9. That sold for $21 on Poshmark. Actually, let me pull up my Poshmark too and just look at the items too, because I just want to breeze through this. On April 2nd, I sold this Liliana Mabel one square open toe weave mule. This reminded me of the Bottega mule, and I've been trying to sell this for since last summer or last spring. So I'm happy to see this go. It sold for $21 on Poshmark. It was like a perfect dupe for that shoe. I can't remember the name of the shoe. Next up is this J. Crew Mercantile Women's Navy Stripe Pleated Line Skirt. I actually got that from my coworker. She gave me a bag of clothes and that sold quick. I sold that for $20 on Poshmark. Tom's Black Mule size, you don't need to know size. Tom Black Mules, that sold for $30 on Poshmark. Next up, H&M Maxi Blue Beach dress, ruffle shoulder blue. This is something I've had. It's from my own closet. I had bought that for summer vacation last year. Didn't use it. That sold for $15 on Poshmark. Yes, you're not going to get a lot for an H&M, but it's better than nothing. Geox. How do you say that? Geox? Wedge sneaker black Oxford. This I got from my mother-in-law. This sold for $20 on Poshmark. This Lucky Brand Distressed Camo Top. This sold for $16. It was new with tags. This sold for $16 on Poshmark. Dansko Nina Heel Sandal Purple. I haven't seen a Dansko like this, so this was cute. This sold for $35 on Poshmark. Next up are Nubuck shoes. Those sold for $49.80 on eBay. That sold April 7th. I don't think you guys care what day it sold. They're all in April. Free People In The Loop Flame Red Leather Boots. Oh my God, these took forever to sell. And, you know, right. It just needed the right buyers. So this sold for $55 on Poshmark. Let me talk about this item. I sold this Francois Jabot. I don't know how to say the first name. Marathi Jabot. It's the Jabot jean vintage 90s jacket. I saw this at the thrift store and I grabbed it because everything 90s is back in style. Right? So one of the YouTube creators that I follow, it's a cute couple. They're based out in, I think, Hong Kong. I want to say Sam and Victor. You should definitely look them up. I just like their stuff. I like their style and everything. I like how they film their videos. So they were, I forgot where they went, but Jabot is a big thing out there. Now, I'm sure it's the new Jabot, and I'm sorry if I'm pronouncing it wrong. But I remember when it was big when I was in high school. I'm dating myself. So I was like, what? They're going crazy. So I'm sure the vintage stuff, it didn't sell for a bad amount, but this was like authentic, like even the style and everything, as you can see for the picture. So I sold this for $59.80 on eBay. and the seller wanted to put in a return. So, I mean, at that time I was like, okay, well, you know, because I accept returns on eBay. And then I was like, when I saw the video, I was like, oh, I could definitely sell it for more. They never returned the item. Nope. So eBay released my earnings. But man, yeah, I wonder if they realized they had a gem in their hand. I don't know how much it would have sold for, but yep. Next up is this Old Navy plum jumpsuit. I had bought that for myself, but I didn't really like how it fit. So I did 2 days, wore it like twice. 2 days, wore it like twice. Sold that for $18 on Poshmark. Future Collective striped asymmetrical long sleeve. If you know about the Kalani Barfield Brown collab with Target, she was one of their first, no, she wasn't one of their first collaborators, but I would say that her collection made a lot of noise in social media. So I eventually I feel like I bought every piece. Maybe I'm missing like two pieces, but I bought every piece. This shirt, nah, I never did anything with it. So had no problem with reselling it, and I sold it, and it sold fast. The minute I listed it that afternoon, it sold for, really? Oh wait, hold on. Yes, because it's like a long sleeve shirt, but it's like a long sleeve shirt dress. You can wear it many different ways. It sold for $52.52 on eBay. Next up is this Anthropologie Belle Kazan Evie jumpsuit. This beautiful, beautiful jumpsuit. This sold for $119.81 on eBay. This Jewel Queen vintage silk sequin top. I've had this forever. This was from my own closet. Have I worn it? No. I've sold this for $25 on Poshmark. I feel like I could get more for that, but this came from my own closet. This Versace bralette sold that for $40 on eBay. Next up is this Free People Loving Good Vibrations White Distress Shorts. Those sold for $38 on Poshmark. Next up, these Jack Rogers Kelly neon sandals sold on Poshmark for $31. This Torrid Black Floral Chiffon Maxi Skirt sold for $40.04 on eBay. This Paige Denim Lace Up Overall Dress, my God, I remember when I bought this. Century 21 was closing in a town nearby me, and I bought a whole bunch of stuff, and that was one of the items. And they were closing before COVID. That's how long I've had this dress. Paige does not sell. Does not. No. I was practically ready to give this away. And this was new with tags. To me, it's a cute dress. Denim is back in. But I've had it for way too long. Way too long. So that sold for $25.45 on eBay. This is my daughter's jumpsuit. I thought it was so cute. We had some fun wearing this. It was her favorite jumpsuit. She's just older now. This Christina Martinez and Nordstrom collab kids print jumpsuit. This sold for $21 on Poshmark. This was something I thought I was gonna wear, but I didn't. H&M Women's Phantom Motif like mesh knit top that sold for $25 on Poshmark. Free People Veil Boot Sandal. Like I said, I'm trying to get through my Free People liquidation lot. This sold for $45 on Poshmark. Leith Women's Black Wide Leg Pants. That's from my closet. That sold for $25 on Poshmark. Because of Alice. Because of Alice, yes, because of Alice wide leg jeans. This is my first time picking up this brand. I don't know if it goes by Boa, but I picked it up. It's so cute. You could tell from the stock photo up there. This sold for $35 on Depop. Oh, this came from my closet. I enjoyed wearing this. This Ralph Lauren vintage green button-down shirt. This sold for $15 on Poshmark. There is a great podcast called... it's going to bother me. But it's all about clothing. It's all about fashion, and it breaks down everything. And they just did... I'm going to link it. I am going to link it below because I can't think of the name. It's escaping me right now. The name of the podcast. Oh, you know what? We'll actually put the name during editing. They did a whole thing on Ralph Lauren. The preppy. It was all about preppy. Eye-opening. Eye-opening. That's what I talk about. I talked in one of my videos about one of the things about being a good reseller or things that I wish I'd have known, whatever that video was. research. Like learning about like the whole preppy vibe and how it came about and how it's like, it is a constant trend that is around. Love it. So you should definitely listen to that. And it's so entertaining. It's so good. She does an excellent job. I just can't remember the name of it. It's going to come to me. So I had this Ralph Lauren shirt. I wore it number of times. I loved it. And I didn't mind selling it. So parted with it, $15 Poshmark. Love Shack Fancy washed silk popover dress. This dress had, it looked like it was sun bleached. And I showed it in one of my hauls. Like it was in a stock, not a stock. It was on a mannequin, like in a window. Like you could just tell because it just looked like the sun had bleached. So it wasn't like, I don't know how to describe it. But like you can upcycle it. And I had put that in my list and like, feel free, you buy this to upcycle. Like, or do whatever it is you want with it, but it is not in its prime condition. This sold for $20 on Poshmark. Next up is this Cezanne robe cedar dress, new with tags. This sold for $35 on Poshmark. Free People in the Loop woven tan booty. This sold for $35 on Poshmark. Free People Fever Pitch Boyfriend Jeans, size 29. This sold for $35 on Poshmark. Do I have to say the date? Because we're on April 19th. April 19th, rookie chop cutout booty. Oh, no, this rookie cutout booty. Steve Madden, snake print. I tore that listing thing up. It's $35 sold on Poshmark. This on April 21st, this Free People Marine Val strappy leather sandal. Also got that from Liquidation. That sold for $35 on Poshmark. On the 21st, this Target mid-rise pants. Oh, this was also part of the Kalana collection. This sold for, I let that go for $20 on Poshmark. That came from my closet. This Free People multicolor Broca gold casual. I don't know why I put casual. This Broca gold mini dress, size 2. This sold, and that was one of my recent hauls. This sold for $35 on Poshmark. This is Ann Dana cotton blue striped dress, sold for $35 on Poshmark. On the 22nd, this Rothy's Terry sneaker, size 8.5, that sold for $35 on Poshmark. These Gentle Souls Naomi gray suede leather, these sold for $25 on Poshmark. That sold on the 22nd as well. This Express ruffle sleeve black dress. I thought this dress was so cute. I had that listed since November. This sold on the 23rd for $25 on eBay. That sold on eBay. This MBM swim magenta cutout Aspire bathing suit, that was new with tags. That sold for $35 on Poshmark. This Mother the Hugger sweatshirt pullover, this sold for $35 on Poshmark. Naked wardrobe meshed up leggings, this sold for $29 on Poshmark. This is Karen Britchick and Amazon, part of the Drop collection. I have some stuff from her as well, but I was happy to let this go. These are the black belted cargo pants, still sold for $25 on Poshmark. That came from my closet. Is ASOS Design pleated shoulder pencil dress. This sold for $25 on Poshmark. Free People Haven Thaw Flatform Sandals. That sold for $35 on Poshmark. Oh my God, I'm so happy to let this go. Happy by Nature. Kate Hudson brand that she had for a quick minute. I thought these dresses were beautiful. And I couldn't get them to sell. They were taking forever to sell. Forever in my books. I listed them back in November. It's the height of spring. I've relisted them a couple of times. Still, like, not that much interest, which I was surprised about. Because they love Kate Hudson, right? People love Kate Hudson. It's cute. It gets, like, Anthropology feels, but wasn't selling. $34 on Poshmark. This Kate Spade printed midi dress. This sold for $20 on Poshmark. These Chacos slide taupe. They seem like pool sandals, not like your typical Chacos. Those sold for $20 on Poshmark. Zara, this came from my closet. Zara Distress Raw Hem light wash jeans. They were just a little too big. Those sold for $25 on Poshmark. These Liberty Leather women's like woven mule. That sold for $29 on Poshmark. Another Kalana Barfield collection. Like I said, I felt like I bought the whole collection. That sold for $29 on Poshmark. Everlane, which I'm done picking them. I'm not picking them up no more. These Everlane corduroys sold for $25 on Poshmark. This Dana Knit two-piece set. I could have did better with the pictures. This sold for $28 on Poshmark. These Lululemon mid-rise line shorts. Those were cute. Those sold for $25 on Poshmark. This vintage nightgown that I found that I thought was just so adorable. It was small though. Gossard Artemis. I had to look that up. They did undergarments and stuff, you know. Legendary. This sold for $25 on Poshmark. Sam Edelman Ashlyn Crisscross Espadrilles. Those sold for $23 on Poshmark. Oh, this is good. We're on April 29th, guys. We're almost done. Keen Women's Whisper Sandals. Those sold on the 29th as well. $35 on Poshmark. And Jeffrey Campbell, Jeffrey Campbell Caceres boots. These were a small size, so I was happy to have them move out of my closet. But they're so cute. Those sold for $25 on Poshmark. Gap High Rise Slit Front Leggings. That was from my closet. I bought two of these. So there's no reason for me to have two. I think I bought two because I was like, oh, I love these so much. I don't ever want to can't get them anymore. So I bought two. But there was no reason for me to buy two. So I sold one. They sold for $25 on Poshmark. Eloquy Women's Striped Side Tie Midi Skirt sold for $29 on Poshmark. Zara Linen Long Jumpsuit. This was adorable. I'm telling you, I love selling Zara. I love it. This sold for $57 on eBay. Oh, buyer pays for shipping on eBay with me for eBay. I do free returns, but the buyers do pay shipping. So the price you're hearing is with shipping, right? So that's fine, right? I should have said that in the beginning. Title IX shorts. I was surprised. My Title IX skirt that I picked up sold fast. These shorts took a while to sell. I thought they were going to move a little faster. I did list them in February, but I just thought they were going to move fast. Those sold for $38.50 on eBay. It's H&M. Y'all hearing? H&M sells. It's H&M apricot dress. It's a size extra large. This sold on Depop for $28. It's a cute dress. This also came from my closet, and I love this. So I'm a sucker for a jumpsuit. I love a jumpsuit. This jumpsuit, I got my cost per rare on this one. I wore this one. The Zara Women Technical Black Jumpsuit. This sold for $20 on Poshmark. And the last thing to sell for the month of April was these Free People Vicente leather slide sandals, and that sold for $31 on Poshmark. You guys. Those are my sales. Those are my sales for April. I think I did pretty good in April. I like how my closet is going. I should have said the dates. I don't know. So I'm sorry. Sometimes I said the date. Sometimes I didn't say the date. But did I have any $0 days? I did. I think I did in April. Let me just check. No sale days. 1, 2, 3. Yeah. April 5th, I had no sales. And April 12th, I didn't have any sales. So I had two no sales. Oh, no. Wait. 1, 2, 3, 4. Wait a minute. I have 4 no sales days in April, which I like. I like to sell every day if I can. So that's a plus to me, especially since I only list 3 items. I'm happy if I have a sale every day. No, I'm not going to increase my listings. Nope, nope, nope. If you know anything about me, this is a reseller reset. I want to enjoy reselling. If you're here to watch me, I mean, I can give you some tips. Maybe you can get some tips from me and go and grow, whatever. But I am a true part-time reseller, hobby at it. There is money in it, but I can't. It was taking over my life, and I was like, nope, nope, nope. Let's step it back. So I just want to enjoy it. And so that's why you'll hear that my prices aren't that high. It works for me. It doesn't work for everyone else, but it does work for me. And yeah, I come across great stuff, good stuff. I come across good stuff. So I'm lucky for that. And I don't mind just like, you know, it getting out to the masses, you know. Retail is expensive and people are thrifting. Thrifting is a trend. People are looking for deals and I don't mind giving it to them. So yeah, that's that. Comment below. Let me know how your April sales are doing. What will be my next video? I don't know what my next video. Did you guys watch the Met Gala? Loved it. I mean, the theme, people say, was a little controversial, but I liked a lot of looks. And it's been a while since I liked a lot of looks from the Met Gala, so, yeah. I think my favorite was Anne Hathaway. Oh, Anne Hathaway, Tiana Taylor, Tom Brown, period. Came, understood the assignment. It was probably easy for them, too, because it was black. But they did the damn thing. And, of course, Riri. Of course. But Anne, to me, is number one. And then after Anne. All right. Anne, Riri. Tiana, I really like Tiana. But the men, no. The men. The men killed it this time. Yep. So let's go like that way. The men killed it, so they get their own. That's Met history for me right there. And then we'll say Riri, because we're going to, yes, she always comes, she always shows out, and Anne Hathaway. But I'm a big Anne Hathaway fan. And then Tiana Taylor. Because that, what? And then Tom Brown as the designer for the night. All right, you guys, that's all I have for you. come back here next week. Sunday is usually my upload days. Well, late Saturday night, so you guys see it Sunday. And yeah, like and subscribe because I am terrible at saying that. And I'll see you in the next one. Have a great reselling week. Bye, guys.